You didn't think I was just going to buy one pair of those boot warmers, did you? I ended up buying this other pair just to see what they were like, and this was a cheaper pair. And looking at them now, well, I'll plug them in. So here's the power meter. And again, they appear to be PTC thermistor elements, so it starts off quite high and it instantly drops down. And then the unearthed metal plate underneath starts getting warm. And also, note the little red LED in here. Oh, it's blinking away merrily there. Blinking away on camera, not visible actually, blinking to the naked eye. So yeah, a little red LED here. And this screwed together cable splitter, which is quite neat. So yeah, these will settle down roughly to about the same, about 10 watts. So let's, before they get too hot, let's unplug them and put that out of the way. And let's open them and see what's inside. I'm not keen on this metal plate at the bottom. I'm thinking, you know, that's not quite as electrically sound as the one that had the plastic shell on the bottom. I'm guessing from these rivets that the PTC temperature, the little heater element, is probably sandwiched directly onto this metal as well, with nothing but a raft of Kapton. I will remember that name at some point. Kapton tape. Okay, how do these come out? Like that. Oh yeah. Oh, that's really shitty. And these, this gets very hot, I'm pretty sure. The other one got up to about 150 degrees centigrade in the middle. So these little tails, the plastic actually feels quite soft and flexible as well. Oh, I'm not 100% sure about that. That looks a bit dodgy. It seems actually quite a small element as well. Compared to the other one, I'm sure the other one was a bit bigger. Yet dissipating about the same power, which means, is that going to end up getting a bit hotter? Anyway, let's take a look in the cable splitter section, now that I've found that I really don't like that bit. Ooh, right, okay. And here we have an LED and a resistor, a 150k resistor in series. Oh, not even soldered there, they're just twisted together there. Soldered onto the leads. Ugh. Is there something fancy about that LED? Is that just, is that LED a bi-directional LED? It's lighting in that direction. It's not lighting that direction. It's an ordinary LED with a resistor in series just banged right across 240 volts. Okay, let's do the maths for the power dissipation of the resistor. So I've just RMS value of 240 volts. I equals V over R. The LED is going to be about 2 volts. So 240 divided by 150k equals 1.6 milliamps, but only half wave. But because the LED will be shunting out when its rear reverse voltage is exceeded, it will be seeing that in both halves, so that's times 240, which means the dissipation of that resistor will be 384 milliwatts, which is above its 250 milliwatt rating somewhat. Oh, God, no, this is shit. I like the little cable splitter. It's quite neat. I don't like the fact that there's an unearthed metal plate at the bottom with something very hot in it and the wire's just going straight onto it, even if it is wrapped in a thin layer of Kapton tape. And I'm not overly convinced I'm really keen in the size of those little PTC heating elements. Shall we take a wee closer look at them? Because to be honest, I'm not going to be using this for heating my boots. So let's pop this off. Try not to damage the wee heating element in case it's actually salvageable. Oh, rightio, it is just two electrodes with a little bit of heater. Look, you know, this looks like it's been snapped in half. This looks like they've taken one of these elements, scored it, snapped it in half, and then stuck a small electrode in the side. Oh, dearie me. That's not impressive. This really is the non-luxury model. But quite frankly, terribly entertaining to take to bits anyway. So, yes, interesting, but I won't be using that one.